This hand is much more suited to fighting a green-white deck than our first one was, because we got a little cheap removal, and that's good. So we're gonna see. We have Abyssinian Priest to worry about, and Nidalis of the Mist, and that's mildly annoying. I think we are going to trade a Deadweight for that. Maybe a Victim. I think we're going to trade a Deadweight for that. Yes. And then we can play Mark of Attrition and then reap the Seagraph. The problem with Nidalis is that we don't know how what the game is going to end up turning like, and we may not just have the time to cast a removal spell later on. So guessing now is going to be better. So here he's not going to attack, and let's see, now we can play Drown Yard and then attack. See what he does. He may just block the priest and we can victim of that, and then that'll be good. I would not mind trading Abyssinian Priest for my Mark of Attrition. And him having the Thraven Sentry means it's more enticing, but he's not, so we're gonna go ahead and play Reap the Seagraph. And so he can spend his time tapping our zombie if he really wants to. Nidalis of the Mist. He doesn't have to. I suppose we should have played the swamp in the case that we draw another swamp next turn, so that's a little bad. And Tribute to Hunger, so let's see. Maybe we can use that to gain five, four life. We're gonna go ahead and he's gonna tap his. And he's tapping that, so he's not going to block. Maybe he will. Nope. So we're gonna go ahead and flash this bad boy back, I think. We can always just tribute him now. He'll probably sack the Nidalis. Then we can victim the Thraven Sentry. But I'd rather just get this guy into play so that he's gotta use his mana on his turn. So in case he draws, in case that changes his, makes his plans less. Make his plans worse for casting creatures. And let's see, he's gonna attack now with his stuff. And let's see what he's got. Now this is gonna make him more inclined to trading off a creature. But nope, doesn't look like that's gonna be the case. He's just going to attack with the Nidalis and then pay four mana to play something. Or maybe pay three and then hold this guy back defensively. Or maybe even not attack with this at all because he wants to trade away the zombie so he can flip this guy. But if he does that, then we'll be able to victim that and then tribute that. And it looks like he's maybe has skillful lunge, so I'm gonna go ahead and block there and see what he has. He could have the now the downside to this is if he has skillful lunge, we can just always wait and play victim on our turn to. And we end up taking an extra two damage that way. So, since we have no more creatures to play, I'm actually a fan of just taking four here and trying to get the Skillful Engine for free. Since I would not be. I would not want to throw this. Ooh, look. That's good. All right. So, now what we're going to do is. Bash for some damage here. So we're gonna bash for four and then wait and see what he does. I can only imagine he's going to cleaver up his Thraven Sentry on his turn, and then we can play victim on that and then victim his priest and then tribute his Nidalis. So we're going to respond to the equip by playing victim just in case he has a forest and ranger's guile. And now he's going to just attack with the Nidalis, and we're going to take it. Then we're going to victim his guy, since he obviously doesn't have Faith Shield. And we're going to go ahead and, let's see, do we have a guy in there yet? Nope. Bash for 7 and play nothing except for an island. Then we can mill and tribute him. Not like the tribute is going to end up mattering too much. Let's see. I mean, it'll be game. Oh, no. Well, all right. So, we don't really want to tribute him in response, so we're going to go ahead and let him do that. All right, so our guy's dead. Seems pretty bad to do that, and that's fine. So we're going to go ahead and tribute him, attack them both. Now we can mill him. He's got a double block, but in case we end up drawing another Stitch Drake, we should just mill ourselves. There's murder. So we are going to go ahead and bash in. He's forced a block. Then we can play Stitch Drake and hopefully, let's see. If he has another Slayer, then I suppose we're in some trouble. But hopefully that's not the case. Hopefully we have managed to take victory from the jaws of our mana screwed opponent. And it looks like that's the case, so I'll see you in round 3, guys.